Welcome to the Vicarage, where stories are told and prayers are prayed. I'm Lisa Fishbeck, Vicar of the Episcopal Church of the Advocate here in Chapel Hill, North Carolina. In this season of the Vicarage, we sit by the Advocate Pond to tell the stories of the women from the great cloud of witnesses, the women of the cloud. Today we join the church in commemorating Prudence Crandall, a 19th century teacher and prophetic witness. Prudence was born to a Quaker family and educated in Quaker schools in Rhode Island in the early 1800s. With a passion for teaching, she started a girls' school in Canterbury, Connecticut in 1831, teaching the daughters of the town's wealthy families. Trouble started for Prudence, though, when in 1833 she admitted a young African-American girl named Sarah Harris to her school. Sarah wanted to learn so that she could, in turn, teach other African-American children. But the parents of the white girls were outraged and demanded that Sarah Harris be expelled. Prudence Crandall refused and instead devoted her attention to transforming her school into a school for African-American girls. Town leaders tried to shut the school down, but Prudence Crandall persevered. She enlisted the help of William Lloyd Garrison, editor of The Liberator, the nation's top anti-slavery newspaper. And word of Prudence Crandall and her school soon spread across the country, and students flocked to her school. So in 1833, the Connecticut State Legislature passed the so-called Black Law, which made it a crime to provide education to any African-American students from outside the state of Connecticut. Prudence Crandall was arrested and jailed and tried. Her conviction in a lower court was eventually overturned in a higher court, but the threats and the harassment only intensified. When students ever ventured beyond the school, they were met with taunts and threats and violence, and some folks even pelted them with eggs and stones and manure. On the night of September 9, 1834, an angry mob broke most of the school's windows and smashed the furniture. Fearing for her students' safety, Crandall finally closed the school. She moved with her husband to a farm in Illinois and started a new school there. She also got involved with women's suffrage and the temperance movement. In 1886, some 50 years later, a petition endorsed by none other than Connecticut resident Mark Twain, expressing regret and shame over the treatment of Prudence Crandall in Connecticut, persuaded the Connecticut State Legislature to award her a pension. Prudence Crandall died in 1890 at the age of 87. In more recent years, she has been declared a Connecticut state heroine. May Prudence Crandall, her persistence and her perseverance, be an inspiration to us all. Let us pray. The Lord be with you. God, the wellspring of justice and strength, we thank you for raising up in Prudence Crandall a belief in education and a resolute will to teach girls of every color and race that alongside her they might take their place in working for the nurture and well-being of all society, undaunted by prejudice or adversity. Grant that we, following her example, may participate in the work of building up the human family in Christ, your word and wisdom, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, now and forever. Amen. Be well.